Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to What the Science, the place where you get your answers with the science behind it. And welcome back to our mini-series, The Black Hole Theory. This is the fourth episode of the series, so if you haven't watched the previous episodes, make sure that you watch it after this episode, so that you can get even more smarter. And don't forget to flex the brain muscles, because we are going to get started. Now, from previous episodes, we have understood that black holes are giant astronomical objects which sucks everything into it and then shredding it into pieces. We also know that, finally, one day the black hole will eventually evaporate due to Hawking radiation. Now, this phenomenon is justified, but what is not justified is what happens to the things which went into the black hole after it dies. By things, we mean what happens to the information that was sucked into black hole. Let's understand first what we mean by information. Information is not tangible. It is just understood as a property of arrangement of particles. For example, let's take some carbon atoms. Now, arranging them in a particular fashion will give you a graphite. But arranging them in a different way will give you a diamond. Now, both graphite and diamonds are basically carbons. But what makes them different is the information of their arrangement. Thus, basic building blocks of all the objects in the universe are the same. But they all have a definite arrangement. Now, without information, everything in the universe will be the same. According to quantum mechanics, information is indestructible. It might change shape, but it cannot be destroyed. Here is where black holes spoils the theory. Information tells us how things are different from each other and what used to be what. Black holes, on the other hand, does the opposite. They take different things and makes them same, thus destroying the information. This creates the information paradox and a serious problem. Because as the black holes suck up things into it, it is destroying the information day by day. But if fundamentals of physics says that information can't be deleted, then is it time to rewrite physics? Maybe not. Now we think that as the black hole disappears, so does the information with it. But till the time a black hole exists, what does it do with the information? Let's understand. Black holes, as we know, is something which is formed due to its mass reaching a threshold value. So a black hole is already full in its capacity. That means every time when something falls into the black hole, it should increase its surface area to accommodate the object. So it turns out that a black hole grows its surface by a tiny pixel for each time a tiny bit of information is thrown into it. So more information means more surface area. The information gets painted on the surface, similar to what happens when we throw a stone in the pond. We know something went into the pond from the ripples, even though we can't see the stone. Black holes, in the same way, can store information painted on its surface in the form of tiny pixels. They do this in the form of a hologram. A hologram is like a 3D photo on a 2D plane. And the black hole is like a hologram, because everything inside it is encoded on its event horizon. This principle is called the holographic principle. If the information is actually stored on the boundary of a black hole, then there is a high chance that Hawking radiation can learn the information and carry it away with it. So the information is not lost even when a black hole dies. So that solves the information paradox. But if holographic principle is true, then our entire universe will be also a hologram. Let's understand. A person inside a black hole will continue to perceive everything in 3 dimension. But one outside it will see the person as a 2D image on the surface. This will be true for our universe too, since the black hole is just a part of it, and it follows the rules of the universe we live in. That means even though we can see every object in 3 dimension, but at the end of the universe, we all will be stretched over a flat screen like a hologram. Now we don't know what the true nature of the universe is. But we are sure that it is weird and complicated. And we have to do a lot more physics to understand it. But one thing is for sure, that black holes might be the key to understand the nature of reality itself. So that's it from this episode of the mini-series. You can watch the previous episodes by clicking on the link above. And if you liked the episode, hit the thumbs up button to let us know. If you have any comments, suggestions and ideas for future episodes, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe, because we make videos every week. Also please depress the bell icon to get notified whenever we post a new video. You can also follow us on Twitter. And do like our Facebook page. All the links are provided in the description below. Thank you for watching. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning.